Hey there, everyone. This is Yui. Welcome to episode 1 of Enigmatica 2 Expert Skyblock. And boy, that's a mouthful. So, today, we're just going to get through some of the basics. I'll show you some things, but I'm going to join Sex Team, who is a little farther ahead than me. So, let's just get to it. Now, when you start off, hopefully it's not nighttime for you. Do I have my brightness up? Yes, I sure do. You're going to start on a tree. Don't fall off the edge. Honestly, the easiest way is probably just going to be to ore excavate the leaves just to see if you get your sapling. Oh, hey, look at that. This is a perfect example of why I wanted to show you this. I got nothing. All right, no sapling, and I'm pretty sure the book does not have a repeatable for saplings. I'm pretty sure. I'm not going to collect that quest just yet. But if you're in this exact predicament, what you can do is do slash island, leave, all right? Type it again to confirm. There. All right, and that'll bring you back to spawn. Now what you can do is you can join another person's island, or you can just create a new one. With slash island, create. And then boom, you've got a new tree to deal with. I lost my quest book. That's okay. It clears your inventory. Which is understandable. So you don't get all the stuff and then move along. Really? Wow, what horrible luck. Twice in a row. Okay, but what you... I can't believe that. Wow, okay. Here's my recommended start. This platform is 3x3. It's too high. So what I like doing is just pick one of the sides, dig down one block, wait for the grass to spread to this dirt block. You can do it to multiple sides if you want. But then you can use this dirt to expand your platform. And you'll get grass. Grass down here. That way you can have just a little extra boost and a place to spread bone meal in the future for flowers and seeds. And get actually additions worms. Anyways, I am going to join Sex Island and then see where we're at. So I'll be back in a second. Alright, so here we are. This is where, start of our adventure. Push him off of this. My area. Get off. Get off. There we go. Alright, so let's see what we got going on here. Got a bed. The easiest way to get a bed early, make sure to make a crook. Actually, let's make some tools. With your nice wood. Does he got cobble? Cobble. He's got a cobble gen, I saw it. Right over there. Oh, and here. Here we go, there's two. And yeah, that looks like it. Alright, so what you're going to want to do, I'm not going to do it because that's already done. Gather a bunch of wood, expand your platform so you're not feeling so cramped. He's done that. Make yourself the tinker stuff. Let's see, what's the quest say to do? Actually, get yourself your backpack. A backpack helps. Why not? Make yourself a crafting table. In that crafting table, just the leather around the frame will get you a cheap small backpack. Just trying to pull out the inventory from there. Can I put something in there? No. Oh well, that's fine. In your backpack goes the diamond wand because I don't use it. I'm lazy, but I don't like the wands too much. I use them sometimes. Not for wood though. Anyways, expand your platform a little. Make lots of trees. Trees, trees, trees. In fact, he needs more trees going because he doesn't have got a lot of wood. But we'll get to that. Once you get some wood, make yourself the tinker's set, the whole set. Station, tool station, part builder, pattern chest, and the stencil table. Remember that the pattern chest has has two recipes. A chest, which is actually the more expensive recipe versus just surrounding it with logs. Make sure you do the second one. Don't waste your chest that you get from the quest on that. Alright, let's see here. These chests. Don't waste these chests on that. As for storage, Flint, I'll take. Oh, I don't know. Steel. Give me steel. Steel's harder to get usually. Oh, here you go. Here's some replacement saplings. Also, in case you have bad luck like I did twice in a row. Twice. Not once. Twice. Alright. Let's see here. Mob farm. ASAP. They are not lying. You will need a ton of gunpowder. And in order to progress to cobblestone, you need gunpowder. In order to actually... Here's the mob farm he made. Walk over here in my slow-mo. Baby zombies, I hate those things. But here you go. It's a nice, simple, big, long. I don't like these types, but it works. Don't you yell at me. Look at all quest completing. Keep up to date on your mob farm. Can't stress how important it is. Do it. You will need to make... Let's just go through the quest because it should be coming up right here. The wooden combustion set. You can do this with the trapdoor. That's okay. Let's see, does he get it? This. And this. This. And a trapdoor. Actually, we'll take all that. So, the way this should look is you will, once you make these, they're pretty cheap. You will need gunpowder, so get your mob farm first. It's all wood, though. Like that. A building block on top. Fill in the four sides. Now the fun part is getting up there with nothing. Is that a creeper? Oh, jeez, what the heck? Oh man, regular bow sucks. Are you gone? Okay, let's just take a pause and fix that problem first. As much as I enjoy creepers blowing stuff up, that is not exactly what I had in mind. Let's just F7 real quick. Yep. Here you go. I can't even see up there. I'm so slow. I can't jump high. Everything's wrong. This needs a light. And my new death machine over there needs a light. But that's all right. All right. So when you're doing these, you're going to need a way up. So I just use... I use slabs. Not going to... forget it. I don't care. I'll make a thing later. Fine. Here we go. This is what the combustion chamber looks like that they want you to make, and just put a button on it. He's got the upgraded stone one, so there's no point in me making this. Now there is the Draconic Evolution hack in this pack. If you're not familiar with it, this top block. So when you right-click this, it'll say not formed. But if you take a piece of wood, say, or if you're on stone, stone, and use your Draconic Evolution place. Oh, it doesn't work for this one. Ooh, they fixed this one, but not the cobble one. Is that true? Yeah, totally. So this one, you can do cobble on top. So this one, just use a trapdoor then. When you upgrade to wood, though, use the Draconic Evolution place button, put a piece of cobble there, and it'll act like a sealed unit. And thus, you don't have to keep opening and closing it and wasting heat. So let's go through and make some quick tools. We need a pickaxe. We're going to do that out of stone. We need an axe. And then everything else is wood because he didn't get enough stuff just yet. Need that. Need one for here. We need one for a sword. We need one for a comma. We need... we need four. Four for a crook. One for a hammer. And I think that's it. Okay. You're good. We need one of you. One of you. one of you, which I'm just going to upgrade, so I don't know why I'm making it out of wood just yet. One for the comma, one for the hammer, one for the pickaxe, and I think that's everything. Okay, so your crook, make one of these. I recommend making the Tinker's one rather than the one just made with four sticks, because this one you can repair and upgrade and make it better over time. Pickaxe. Standard pickaxe. Comma next, because why not? Then we need a hammer. There's a tool binding still in there. And then let's get our sword. Madoc. And we're done. Look at this mess of junk. Okay, our death machine hasn't spawned anything, so that's good. Let's get rid of all this. Get that back. Okay, so what you need this guy for is making blaze powder. Blaze powder is made with gunpowder, and you need a lot of blaze powder, so keep up with that mob farm. Dump all this junk. Sure, sure, gone, gone, gone. Chest will keep. Need inventory here and here. Perfect. There we go. So like I said, let's see, do we have any? No. There's no gunpowder. We need cobble, though. Is there really no gunpowder in here? There really isn't. Kind of bum rush through this stuff instead of grinding it out, which is fine. What is that? Oh, that's a torch. Okay. I thought there was an X, which means spawn location. Spawn locations here are bad. Very bad. So, don't do that. Got an infinite water source. Okay, so let's go through some of these things, actually, because it helps to know. There is a guide. Alright, if you're following this guide, you're going to want to follow this one. Grass. So there's only... Stage 1 is the same. The other islands are not in here, so you don't have to worry about them. Which is wood. Then you move on to Stage 2. So you can ignore all the rest of those. But then starting from here down, you're going to go in order. So they want you to get glowstone. Which, how do you do that? You're going to use combustion. Well, it's not a... Is it a combustion heater? Yeah, I guess so. Which, it'll explain it here. Does it show you how to set it up? It tells you... It tells you stuff. But, follow that. Water extractor. Pretty much just follow this guide. This is just Sky Resources' way of generating resources. It'll tell you all the stuff you need to know. Default key is G, but it might overlap, so you might have to change it to something else. So, water, you get a water extractor, you take it from the leaves, and then you can place it like a bucket, and that's what he's done here. Dirt, you can make in these barrels, so if you need more dirt, make yourself a barrel, throw in... Well, plant material. Honestly, the best way that I like to do, take your tree, plant it, take... Oh, that's a big tree. That's a biggins. Get a comma, let's upgrade it. See, that lasted long. Shear the leaves with the comma. It. This many leaves? Yeah, it broke. That's fine. Now with these leaves, there's a couple things you can do. One of them is make bone meal, which will this, well, it's not bone meal, it's plant matter, but it acts like bone meal, except it's better because it's not like a chance to grow the tree. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that, but there we go. We got a floodlight. It just grows the tree. So you can do that. And the other thing is you can take it and about 8 pieces. Or 9, 8 or 9, I don't know, what is that? That was 8. Put it in the barrel and it'll compost into dirt. So make sure you get yourself plenty of dirt so you have plenty of room to grow stuff. Okay, let's just repair this guy. Where are you? Here and here. Sorry, we're just playing catch up at this point, which is okay with me. The other thing to do when you first start off is make a crook. Although we have cobble now. With cobble, take one. And it goes here, where the dust is. So it'll turn your wooden one into a stone one, which will give you 128 durability. If you put it in another slot, it's going to lower it. Make sure it's this one here. And then you can crook the leaves. You'll get extra saplings, extra apples, but more importantly, you'll get silkworms. And with silkworms, you can plant a new tree. Let's just go through that real quick. Plant you. Grow you. Is that another big one? No, okay. And you just put a silkworm there. And what it'll do is it'll start infesting it. What I like doing is, since usually you get a ton of silkworms, just go opposite. And the tree will slowly turn white. And we need food. We're starving. Did you get an apple in here? Yes. There you go. Another nice beginning tip. Take a sapling, three of your apples, make an apple sapling. Plant this somewhere out of the way so you don't accidentally cut it down. We're going to drop it here. Where's my dirt? Give me some dirt. Oh! I needed that. Fine. I didn't want it anyways. Oh, F7's still on. Turn that off. Put your little tree down. You can grow it with this also, and this will have apples on it. These apples will grow over time. I think you can bone them. Yeah, you can bone meal them. Or plant matter them, whatever you want to call it. And that'll get you a reusable supply of food. Is it great? No. Do we have random things? I didn't check. Can we smelt you? It doesn't look it. That's a shame. But random things is in here, right? Was it not random things? It's tiny progressions. Nope, we don't have tiny progressions. That's fine. That if you do have tiny progressions, usually you can smelt the apple into really good food. Alright, tree is white. What that means is ore excavate it, and you get string instead of saplings. With the string, you can make a bed. And that's how there's a bed here. And then we get the wood because we need that too. Alright, what else is there? There's that guy. Clay. So the easiest way I find to get clay is if you are in the cobble phase. I need a new hammer. I need to upgrade my tools. Sorry, this is a lot of catch up still. Even though this isn't very far into it. We need that, we need this one. And that's good enough. You go upgrade, nope. Upgrade the sword. Upgrade the hammer. Repair this one. Good enough. Alright. With your hammer, this acts like the Ex Nihilo hammers. These ones. So instead of making these guys, just make yourself one of the Tinker's ones. Come over here. If you excavate it, it'll turn it into gravel. The gravel you put down. Break that, you get sand. Break the sand. You get dust. This is the Ex Nihilo way of making clay, not the Sky Resources way. Need water. You got a bucket. I know he has plates, so early on, when you get your clay, you can make the coke brick, just one. That'll get you iron plates. Iron plates, you can turn into, not here, into a bucket, because the bucket recipe is different for the expert mode. We have a bucket. This is, he'll live. I'm going to move it. I like to keep one of these right by the water. Wash away. Here we go. That's not really necessary because this one's going to be used for water. But here you go. You put a bucket of water in. And then dust. And it turns to clay. So, water, dust, clay. And that's the easiest way to get it. The other way to get it is dirt plus the water ejector, or extractor, whatever. If you make the compressed one, it just holds more. And it does a bigger range, I believe. Which is not important for this. But what you would end up doing is don't do this near your dirt that you want to keep. Get a piece of dirt, put it somewhere separate. Get your water, and then just right-click it. And that's how you can get your initial clay to make the brick in order to get the stuff to get a bucket. I don't think you can right-click it in here. Right, you cannot. Sneak right-click. Nope. So while this acts like a bucket for the world, you can't use it to insert stuff into machines. So that's just a quick way to get caught up on clay. We don't need that. Look at all this junk. Here's a merge button. This will merge whatever you have with stuff that's already in storage. If it's not in storage, it'll stay in your inventory so you can put it somewhere else. So I'm just going to dump this stuff here, and let's go through these quests again, double check where we're at. We're still playing catch up. Oh, here you go, you gotta start with a dirt furnace before you can make a regular furnace, and you can get your Inferium essence. Get your essences from your mob farm. Upgrade it. This will be, what is it like? It's not much. It's really not much. 15% more efficient, so it'll use less fuel, but only if you're smelting a lot of stuff. I keep opening the wrong thing. Claim all. There we go. There you go. Here's telling you about water. This is... okay, this is telling you to follow the guide to get cobble, which is basically get gunpowder, turn it into blaze powder using the combustion heater. Take 4 blaze powder, combine them into a block, and actually the first one you do is you put it down and you put a torch under it and it'll turn it into a lava source. The ones after that is if you put a crucible on top of that, you can just toss them in here with the Q button. And that'll get you a bucket of lava. Well, not the bucket, just the lava. Let's open these up and see what we get. Anything good? Oh boy, an offset wand, yay, thank you, I don't want it. Donuts, okay. I don't know if that's useful yet. A sleep charm, alright. Ooh, hey, we got a solar panel. I love it. More food. We got a rail gun, which I can't shoot anything with, but we can maybe charge it. Get off. Bye. I'm going to drop, actually here, you know what? Sleep charm. You put one of these on, and you sleep. Sleeping is like instant. So they're cool. But solar panels are cool too. We can charge the railgun. And if I had iron, I could shoot them. These railguns, they shoot rods. So anything that's like rod shaped, I believe like these iron rods, these steel rods, the aluminum rods, and graphite things, these ones, the electrodes, they'll shoot that stuff for ammunition. Are they good? I don't know. But I've got one. I'm going to put that away. Keep one of each food. Spice of Life Carrot Edition is in this pack, so you will need to eat a variety of food, just like in Enigmatica 2 Lite. So much junk. Double check the quests while I still ramble on. Okay. I think we're caught up. So he just made Coke breaks. Are the recipe changed for that? I didn't even look. Actually, it is. You need bone meal. Bone meal for your clay. That's the difference. Is sandstone? I think that's regular. Yeah. Go get your mob farm going and keep it up to date. Anyways, I think we're caught up. Did I miss anything? I really want to show this off just in case. So I'm going to be back in a moment. I'm going to wait for stuff to spawn and get some gunpowder. So see you in a moment. All right. So got a few pieces of gunpowder and some miscellaneous foods from quests. I've been raiding the chest. What can I say? So when you get your combustion heater, make sure it is built and you have to give it furnace fuel basically. And that'll fill the heat up. When you come up top, this is why the draconic hack is nice. Remember, place your block. In this case, we're going to need two of these to make a bucket of lava. It's expensive. Okay. Collect it. There you go. Six blaze powder, but turn four of them into a block. And what you could do with that, we're going to need this later, so I'm not afraid to do it. Remember the first one, place it down and put a torch under it, like the crucibles, kind of. I don't know if you can do it in the crucible with a torch. I'm not sure. You could try it. It doesn't hurt. But throw it in, and it will convert into a bucket of lava a little slow, but it'll happen. And boom, there you go. Bucket of lava. You'll need those. So that's how you get your first lava, which means you can make a cobble gen, which means you can upgrade everything to cobblestone. It's great. Lovely. Keep up with your mob farm. Seriously, it is very important. Don't let it waste, especially the creepers. Creepers are good. Bone meal is good. You need bone meal to make the porcelain. And rotten flesh is actually a good source of early game food if you don't want to make an apple tree. In fact, let's just go through that real quick. I don't see it set up around here. So if you take slabs of wood, I'm only going to make a couple of these. Or four, sure. Four sounds good. And we'll show you another trick. String, apple, more string. Hey, you can make this cheap fishing rod. It is two sticks and a string. It's not very good, but this thing will eventually fish up other fishing rods. It'll also fish up various types of saplings in case you want them. What do we get? We got a stick. Oh boy, thank you. Thank you. You get lots of junk. This is a junk thing, but you can get fish. Or you can just make a regular fishing rod. That's cool too. But this one, you can get leather. So you can either take your fish, melt it down to get leather, or you can fish up leather. It's up to you. That's fine. Oh, look at that too. I am on a roll with this leather. This rod is unbreakable, so it is a really good way if you're bored. A bowl. The stuff you get is just so fun. Oops. I was in the menu. I wasn't ready. Wasn't ready. You do need water for this though. So this is one of the starts in Project Ozone 3, I believe, is you start with the fishing rod. And I like this start because it's nice and relaxing. Fishing. See, that's stuck. No, stop. Stay on top. The fishing is nice and relaxing. It's something to do. See, look at that pair of boots. Now I am half an armor thing, more protected. But when you get 5 pieces of leather, you can make a sack from cyclic right here using this recipe. This is like a cardboard box, which should be in here also. Oh boy. Okay, yeah, you can use sawdust as well if you want to make a cutter. Cutter, cutter. That's a compressed one. Not a cutting knife, it is a grinder. This one. Right? Let's just double check before I tell you lies. Cobble. Two sticks? Yeah. No, that's a wand. Two cobble. There you go. Grinder. Piece of wood. Maybe more. If you dig that up, you can get sawdust. Is it useful? Sure, not really. But with sawdust, you can make a cardboard box, which acts like the sack, so this is your other option, in which case you can move inventories. Put it on something, and you can move it around. In case you have a large crate somewhere or a chest and you want to move it but don't want to empty it first, you can make a box. Pretty simple. Look at him go to work, mining that cobble. He lost his cave. Wonder what happened. Maybe he burned it off. Had it yesterday, not there today. But oh, that's right. I got distracted. You let me get distracted. Drying racks. I'm gonna put them on the back of the chest here. Cheap food, rotten flesh. Put it here. It will very slowly, super slowly turn into monster jerky. Similarly, you can take a fish. Go. Okay. Okay, fine. That's fine. Fish in the furnace. Well, cooked fish. Take the cooked fish, put it on the drying rack, and you'll get leather. 8.5 minutes, so it's not fast. But it is a way to get leather. So you can get leather pretty quick in this pack. So go for it. Anyways, I think we're caught up pretty much. I don't think there's much else to show just yet. So I am going to start the resource grind and then maybe episode two. So if you made it this far, thanks for watching. And we'll see you next time. Bye bye.